Hello students, welcome to the online session for the subject of industrial safety. This subject of industrial safety is mainly for the students of civil engineering, particularly structural engineering, and for the student of mechanical engineering. Here we are going to discuss the each and every topic regarding the industrial safety. Whatever the topics that are given in the G2 syllabus of the subject of industrial safety will be discussed in this virtual session. We will be having a brief discussion on each and every topic. We will be discussing the practical application of this subject of industrial safety in our session also. So let's start with our session. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Hello students. Welcome to the online session for the subject of industrial safety. Here now we are moving towards the last module of our syllabus that was given by GT. In that the last module, the name is periodic and preventive maintenance. Means it is mainly dealing with how and why and what kind of periodic maintenance of the machine are required to be done and what are its effects and what its benefits are. These all are things will be going to be discussed in this module. So let's start with our session. Mainly here there is a term which name is maintenance. So first of all, a question may arise in your mind that what is maintenance? Why we are maintaining the machine or equipments? Means why we are performing the maintenance of something? Maintenance can be done of anything. For example, a machine, a house, a building, a crop, or any kind of a thing. Each and everything that is working do require maintenance. Let's have a brief discussion on this. Here, the video behind me seen that there is a saw cutting of the plants. Means here the maintenance of the crops is being done. There we are cutting the crops. We are maintaining its dimension so that the haphazardly grown crops will be removed. And the unnecessary crops or the dried crops which are having a negative impact on the growth of the plant or the crop is removed. And ultimately, the maintenance is being done, and throughout its life, while doing the maintenance, if the maintenance is being done daily, then during its whole life, the plant will be in a good condition. So for that purpose, it is necessary to have proper maintenance. Maintenance means we are supplying something, for example, supplying nutrients to the plants. We are cutting down the dried branches of the plants. And this is how the maintenance of the plant used to be done. This is just an example why we need a maintenance in our life. Even people also require maintenance, and machine required a lot of maintenance because it is being working daily. And those machines that are working daily do require maintenance because the operation will be taking place. And here we can see that plant maintenance is being done. We are just removing some soil so that some air can pass through it. And as a result of this, the bacteria that is present to get the air. And as a result of this, they will perform their action. Means they will perform their work, and because of that aeration, the proper working of the fertilizer and the worms and other insects will be done. And as a result, the growth of the plant will be improved. So this is how the maintenance is done in crops. Similarly, we are performing the maintenance to our machine also. Maintenance is not only just provided to the machine. We are doing the maintenance of the building, the immovable properties, or even a small bench, a small non-living thing that is being used for some purpose required maintenance. So in order to make any equipment work properly during its design life, it is required to do their maintenance. So this is why we are requiring the maintenance. So let's have a further discussion on the maintenance. So first of all, let's see a definition of the maintenance. Maintenance work is a work that is carried out to preserve the property of the asset. Asset can be anything. It can be either a building, a machine, a heat boiler, or anything. So, mainly we are doing something, we are performing some activities by which the property of that asset will be maintained, and as a result of this, it can be used properly. Its functions can be used properly during the design life without any kind of unforeseen renewal or a major repair. So this is the clear-cut definition of the maintenance. We just need to perform some work, and as a result of this, that particular object or that particular equipment will be used properly, and its design life will be also increased, and throughout its design life, not much repair work is required to be done. If some lack of the repairing work is being done, or if there is a casualty in the maintenance work is being done, then there is a definitely chances of occurrence of the repairing work. So, in order to reduce that extra cost of maintenance or extra cost of the repair, it is necessary to do the maintenance work regularly. So, this is a proper definition of the maintenance work. And here, I think that all of you have got the proper principle of the maintenance work. Why we are performing the maintenance. Further discussing it. Now, what are the reasons for maintenance? Why we need a maintenance work in our building, in our equipment, or any kind of a thing? The first thing is the physical integrity. In order to keep the asset good working, so as to minimize the disruption and the downtimes. In order to reduce the downtimes, means in order to reduce the obstruction of working, it is necessary that the maintenance work is required to be done. And as a result of this, the physical integrity will be maintained, the machine will be stopped for a lesser period of time, and there will be a less disruption of the work. And ultimately, the work will be continued for a long time. This is the first reason why we need a maintenance work. Next reason for the maintenance work is the risk management. In order to keep the asset in a good condition, so that the owner's health and the worker's health will be maintained. Machine is being properly maintained, then there will be a less chance of the damage on the person that is dealing with it. For example, workers are dealing with that machine. They are operating the machine, they are manipulating the machine. So, if the proper maintenance work is not being done, then there is a chance of the damage to the lives of that workers. So, it is necessary that the maintenance work is required to be done. And by this, the chance of the occurrence of the accident will be reduced. And ultimately, the life of the workers will be also saved. Moving on to the further discussion on the risk management. So, in risk management process, mainly we need to assess the risk. What are the risks that are associated with the equipment or dealing with that equipment should be assessed first. Then we need to have a control on all that risk. All the risks that are associated should be controlled. It should be properly reviewed, and proper assessment of that risk should be done. And as a result, we will be completely identifying the risk, and on complete identification of the risk, we can get a solution, or we can say that we can get a way to defend such kind of risk. We can get some solution so that the hazards or the accidents that can take place can be cured. And this is how the risk management is beneficial to the industry. Moving on to further discussion of the some other reason, that is, next is aesthetic preservation. In order to maintain the aesthetic of the machine, we need to keep maintaining it. If we want that the physical appearance of the machine should be kept in a pleasant way, or it should be kept in a proper way, then it is necessary that the proper maintenance work is required to be done. And as a result of this, the deterioration of the appearance will not take place and the machine will be in a pleasant way. It will look pleasant on its first watch. So this is why, in order to keep the aesthetic preservation, we require a maintenance work. Next reason is the responsible stewardship. So in order to ensure the asset achieve, in order to ensure that the asset is achieving its potential service life during its whole life, we need to have a maintenance work. If we want that the machine should work properly during its desired life or the designed life, then maintenance work is the must. So that is how the maintenance do affect the potential of working of the machine. Moving towards the further reasons for the maintenance, next is duty of the care. So in order to satisfy the legislated duty, that is a person or any kind of a owner that is owing that equipment will be satisfied. If the machine has got damage, then it will not be owed by any kind of a person. And we can't justify the ownership or the legislation purpose of that equipment. So for doing so, proper maintenance work is required to be done. Next is duty to mitigate. If we want to prevent the unnecessary damage to the asset that can cause because of the premature failure, then for that purpose, the maintenance work is required to be done. If we want that the premature failure should not occur, then the first thing that is required by the equipment or the machine will be nothing but the maintenance. If the maintenance work of the machine is being done properly, then there is no chance of the occurrence of the failure. And as a result, the desired life of the machine will be raised and it will be serving for a long time a quality product. So these are all the reasons for the maintenance. Now moving towards the next topic, that is different types of maintenance are being listed over here. The first is the breakdown maintenance, second is the preventive maintenance. The further subcategory of the preventive maintenance are periodic maintenance and the predictive maintenance. Then next type is corrective maintenance. So these are all the different types of maintenance. Now let's discuss first type of maintenance, that is the breakdown maintenance. Breakdown maintenance is a type of maintenance where the repairing work is only done once some breakage has been taken. Only when some failure used to occur, the repairing work will be done. So in this type of maintenance, personnels are waiting for the occurrence of the failure. Once the failure will take place, then at that time the repairing will be done. The maintenance work done will be at the time only. So this is how the breakdown maintenance is. This kind of maintenance is mainly done at the places where a significant obstruction of the work is not much affecting the industry. A significant effect of operation, it is mainly taking place when the equipment failure does not significantly affect the production or generate any kind of a losses other than the repair cost. So wherever there is not much effect of the obstruction of the work, at that place the breakdown maintenance work will be adopted. So this is how the breakdown maintenance work is being taken. Moving towards the next type of maintenance, that is the preventive maintenance. In preventive maintenance, we are maintaining the equipment or any asset from the starting only. From the day one of the usage only, we are providing maintenance to the equipment so that no kind of damage can take place, no kind of failure can take place. Here, the activities that are involved daily will be the cleaning, the inspection, the oiling and retightening of the bolts that have loosened because of its working. So such kind of activities are being done daily, and as a result of this, the daily maintenance will be done, and any kind of a failure will never take place because we are maintaining it daily. We are making the equipments in a healthy condition from the starting only, and because of this, deterioration will be prevented, no deterioration will take place, and periodic inspection will be done. And as a result of this, this method is very much beneficial for us, for the industry, or for any kind of a person, because the chances of the occurrence of the failure or damage will be zero. The work will be carried out continuously, and there will be no obstruction of working. So this is how the preventive maintenance is beneficial. Moving towards the next type, that is the periodic maintenance. Here it is a time based maintenance. Mainly we are doing something periodically. Here we are maintaining it periodically. For example, the activities like inspecting, servicing, or cleaning the equipment, or the replacement of the parts are being done periodically, so that the sudden failure will never take place and other kind of problems will never occur. So this is how the periodic maintenance is beneficial. Moving towards the next, that is the predictive maintenance. Here in this type of maintenance, the service life of the machine is very much important. The key term in this maintenance is the service life, because on the basis of the service life only we are predicting the based inspection, we are predicting the quality of the equipment. On the basis of this service life only we are predicting the condition of the machine. We are also inspecting it, we are diagnosing the crevices or the damage that is being found during the inspection, and by doing so the service life of the machine will be raised. This is how the predictive maintenance is helpful. Further, comparing it with the periodic maintenance, it is based on the present condition. As I have said earlier also, that this maintenance, the keyword that is the condition, the service life, and based on that we determine the quality of the machine, means the condition of the machine, and as a result of this we will do the maintenance work. Moving towards the next type of maintenance, that is the corrective maintenance. Corrective maintenance mainly improves the equipment and its components, and by doing so the preventive maintenance will be carried out. Basically in this method of maintenance, the weakness are being identified, the weakness of the machine are being identified previously only, and by redesigning it or by doing some improvement work, we will be rectifying that weakness, and as a result of this improvement can be found and a good condition of the equipment can be maintained. Ultimately, the design life of the machine will be raised and it will have a good productivity and efficiency. So this is how the corrective maintenance is helpful. So this was our session. Thank you for attending this session. So here we are ending our session. Hope you have liked the session. We have discussed each and every topic in brief and also in detail. We have discussed each and every topic's practical application also. So thank you for attending the session, and if you have any kind of a doubt, if you have any kind of a query, then you can send me your doubts and queries in mail. My mail is in my YouTube channel. Do check into my YouTube channel, like it, share it, and again thank you for attending the session. See you in the next session. Thank you.